Hello there, and as usual, I'm Aaron from Last Stand Gamers, and welcome. So today, I want to show you around one of my cargo vessels. Now, a little bit of time ago, I was asked, do I ever build any sort of civilian type of ships? And I looked through my list of worlds, and I found out that I had built very little sort of civilian ships. Most of my designs were orientated around war. So I thought I'd actually dip out and just try to find one design that wasn't too war orientated. You'll notice as I got through this design, I started adding weapons and I just couldn't stop myself as usual. But we went for a nice, clean exterior cargo sort of interior. So from a distance, this ship is going to look just like a cargo vessel. You could even paint it up maybe in more cargo colors. You could have nice blues, nice reds, but I've gone with this sort of purple alien design. We've also got the underhanging tail part of that that's holding some more of the thrusters, giving that more power. It's a very fast ship, as you'll see, so it can get out of very sticky sort of jams with pirates and other sort of situations. A really necessary thing for a small sort of cargo vessel. As we get inside, we'll also notice how I've segregated some of the cargo and the production areas. And you could just use this sort of ship to resupply maybe a battling fleet or just to transfer supplies between outposts in whatever place you are fighting. Now, you may see these little turrets that I've put around the place, very unnecessary sort of designs. They're kind of tucked away though from a distance. You wouldn't notice that this ship is really armed at all. But as you come up close, you'll notice that it's got a little bit of firepower. And I got a lot of inspiration for these turrets from like B-17s, the bombers and the Lancaster bombers, where they've got these really nice glass cockpits that I'll show you when you get inside. And I wanted to build some sort of targeting system that folded down, but there just wasn't enough space inside. So let's continue on and we'll enter through the back. So we've got cargo containers on all sides, all connected up, ready to supply the ship and produce a lot of raw materials. We've also got a little cargo fighter on top that could be used to possibly transport the freight around or towards different sorts of cargo ships or maybe even battling vessels. Well, that's still really in early stages at the moment, and you'll see why I placed that on there. It's more of a disguise. So if we come around the back, we'll actually find one of the many entrance ways through this nice concealed airlock, and we can just drop on and land in gears, and there we go, open this door, and we've got gravity inside here into this chamber. And as we come up, we come into the production bay. So you're going to notice there's two large Sage thrusters just at the back on both sides of these walls, and here we have the actual refinery. So what happens is we refine the actual material, it gets produced, and up there is the cockpit. You can see it leads up to that ladder and up a shaft, and then we've got two times the assemblers. And now this is where I got a little bit out of hand. You're probably wondering, what the hell is going on in that chamber? Well, this is where I started adding weaponry, and I kind of regretted it. I wanted to keep the ship as civilian as possible, but then I just started coming up with loads of different ideas of folding weapons that turn out and have really compact packages. So this ship is really just filled with thrusters and cargo containers, but I wanted to have some hidden sort of disguised weaponry. So that's what I've managed to do here, get this really compact, really tightly within the ship, just really nice to actually use. And we'll continue on a little bit further, and we enter the reactor room. Reactor room, really simple, connected up from the front. And now we're entering the storage bay. The storage bay is just towards the front. We've also got a lower reactor there to give that extra power we need for these Sage thrusters. And like I was saying before, I found it really important, a really good idea to segregate this sort of ideas of building all your constructing all your items at the back of the ship and then storing them all at the front. Because if one of the area is destroyed, say the production is destroyed, you'll still have your storage. If the storage is destroyed, you'll still be able to produce your items. So then you're not really out of pocket when you're trading or you're trying to build other ships. So if we go through here, we'll go towards the front turret. So we just need to hop up, maybe use a bit of our jetpack. We'll actually enter this front turret that's there. We can see we've got some nice glass windows. We've got left and right movement. We've got up and down, and we've got access is locked. So you can just see we've got this really cool sort of perspective. If we had the guns on here as well, click on that. Now, what the only problem that I've really noticed is this is the recoil's a little bit powerful, so I'm going to have to probably orientate the cannons so one fires offset to each other so you get a good rate of fire as well as a lot of impact on the target. And I'll show you that I've done that with one of the other cannons at the back. So I'll just fire these for you. Notice a lot of recoil at the moment. A little bit of a problem with that. But that is going to stop a small fighter from approaching. These are them CSD 88mm cannons. So if we fire them again, can just see the sort of recoil.
It's so crazy having a little cool little turret there at the front just to pop people off as you're going past. Anyway, we'll hop out of that and we'll head towards the turrets at the back, unfold everything out, and I'll show you some of the experimentation that I've done as well. So to get up to the crew quarters or the commander sort of deck, we need to head back through the ship, take a right here, close this door behind us, seal that pressurized area, and then we're going to take this ladder up here, and then we're just going to fly up the shaft, and we'll go onto the upper deck level. So I'll just open this little blast door, and we should have the option of going left or right. And since we're on so many of these cargo containers, the surface that we're walking on is just a little bit hard to actually manipulate. So back there is the rear turret, so we'll just hop on that quickly and show you. Exactly the same, but more of a sort of rear B-17 turret. This one's been locked in place. And then all you have to do is obviously add the weapons to the list. We'll fire this one as well. And there we go, fired away. Absolutely beautiful.
So through this door ahead is the cockpit. Now it's quite a simple sort of survival cockpit, nothing too complicated. And I'm going to show you one of the actual hidden features of this ship. Now imagine that you're in some sort of firefight. You have a big problem. You're a cargo ship. You've not got many weapons. Or maybe you're refueling a larger battleship and that battleship comes under attack and you're a very vulnerable target. It'd probably be a good idea just to get out of there. Or you could pull back to a further distance and assist that ship. Now the two weapons on the front and back are okay, but I think we need a little bit more firepower without ruining that civilian sort of silhouette from a distance. So let's actually fold out some of these extra weapon systems that you saw in the hull below. So I'm going to raise these up. So we've actually got two Flak 4-barrel CSD cannons that are actually ready to rock on the back there. So we can actually aim them both to the side. I'll actually hop out here. I've cut this little hole in the top for just quick access so I don't have to run through the ship. But these would already be manned. The people would hop in inside, and then as they come up to this level, you could actually hop aboard and you'd be ready to fire. So we're inboard the actual compact one. This one's got his cannons a little bit further back to make them more compact. And we can just aim that out to the side like so. We'll aim the other one as well. Now this is just the same as the front one. Hop in the side and we can actually unlock our rotors like so, and once they're unlocked you can actually move them freely, so that just helps when you're actually moving the ship. So now you've got a lot of firepower on what you'd consider maybe a civilian ship. So let's actually stick up a target and we can actually have a look at the damage. So I'm manning the gun. I've got myself some targets set up. We've got one that's just dropped below the actual firing position. We then have to quickly access our weapons tab, drop the weapons tab on. Once we've got them equipped, we should have four target cursors and we can fire away. So you can see we've got a lot of firepower in this thing and we can quickly eliminate little ships. And you can see the firepower just to kick on these larger targets. Let's fire at a big target. You can actually see we punched a massive hole in the side with the four cannons. Now if you orientated these, you fired them one by one, you could fire a lot more as well. Let's have another shot at that smaller ship. There we go, we've eliminated its engine bay. Let's take one at that moving target. And you can track fast moving targets with these rather easy. You can just track across the sky, take them out like so, and fire away. And as you can see, I've not actually synchronized that weapon there, so it fires separately. But that'll just be a little bit more of a buttons and turning different buttons off at the same time. So we can fire one more at this target. Oh, punched a nice bit of hole. And I love the idea of having a lot of firepower like this disguised in what would be a civilian ship. I mean, from a distance away now, it looks like quite a weaponized ship because you've got weapons at the front, back, side, and rear. But if you do took these weapons away, then you have a much more civilian type of profile, so you could get through the areas, and maybe you could even use it as a sort of an assassination ship. You could just have maybe one of these little turrets in your smaller ship. You roll it out, and as that other ship goes by, you take out its cockpit and just drive off really fast. But I don't know. It's just a nice little idea I thought I'd share with you today. Show you a more civilian ship, even though it got a bit more weaponized. But I'd like to thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you next time.